What up, what up, what up?
It's not your boy E.T.
It's the squad.
And we just want to thank you guys, man, for the support throughout the year. And from our family to yours, we just want to wish you happy holidays. You know, let's finish this year out strong, and we'll see you guys in 2016.
Woo!
Thanks, guys.
He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed, as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.
If you are not satisfied with your life, if you had an idea that, you know, by this time in my life, I would be here and you're not there, there's something wrong with the blueprint. And you need to go back and look at the blueprint, change the blueprint, then move forward. What I want you to really think about is the gaps. What are the gaps? Like, I can't seem to get in a relationship and stay in a relationship. What's the gaps? Like, bro, I want you to think about it. I keep getting in relationships and I keep attracting the wrong person. What's the gap? Like, what's the gap? Because there's a gap. You know, I keep trying to lose weight and I can't lose weight. What's the gap? And all you have to do is find out, what am I missing, and make a determination when you wake up to say, I'm gonna do exactly what I need to do to get to that. So what happens is, I've been doing my homework on the people that follow me and the people who are successful, the people who are not. So I did like a case study, and I just been studying different individuals. I've been taking notes. I've been looking at their lives. I've been doing my research. And when I looked at the people who are successful versus the people who are not successful, everybody listens to my videos. But there's a group that's listening to my videos and successful, and there's a group that's listening to my videos and they're not successful, or they're not reaching the level of success that they like to reach. And so I did my homework. I told you, I did a case study. I found out that the first group, the non-successful group, I found out that that group was going after stuff. That group started with the cars. That group started with the six-figure income. That group started with the house. That group started with the clothes. I'm there and I don't even want to be there. I got like Louis luggage. I'm not even that kind of guy. I don't even do Louis. Like, I don't even keep up with the whatever kind of bag I got that's like $10. I can't keep up with that. The Louis was forced upon me. I'm being real. Y'all laughing. I'm being real. My wife on Father's Day told me get in the car. I love my wife. She told me get in the car, see, but she made me drive. She said, I got a secret I want to give you. I'm like, all right, where it is? Get in the car. Let's go. I can't tell you where, but drive. I'm like, just drive. We drove an hour and a half before we got to one of them specialty malls with like Gucci, Louis, and she told me, stay in the car. I was like, bet. Stay in the car. I saw them all coming out with a white male behind them. I was like, whoa. I unlocked the car. Like, whoa, what you walking up on my wife for, bro? Like, he was right up on my wife, like right next to her. I'm like, whoa, oh, shorty, what's going on? And then he had some bags. I'm like, oh, my wife was like, relax. Relax, we come bearing gifts. My man got two big bags. I'm like, no, you didn't. I'm like, boo, come on. You know I'm gonna tear it up, flat out. You know I ain't even, I'm gonna scratch it up. She's like, don't worry, they have a compartment. You take this out and you can cover the bag when you put the bag. I'm like, wow, maybe I should keep it. Right, I got the luggage and it's like 360 plus the boom. I'm like, wow, I've never, like, I don't really get into stuff like that, but I put it on the first couple of trips and was like, maybe I can. So I'm not saying that we shouldn't like nice things, because I like nice things. But I realize that the people that go after things and stuff usually don't become massively successful. I discovered that those people who were successful, what they all had in common was they got to the core. So I need you to do me a huge favor. I'm about to say something to you, and I need you to go with me, right? And this has absolutely nothing to do with religion. Somebody asked me about my faith. When we were in the VIP, listen to me, this has nothing to do with religion, right? But my life changed when I joined the church, right? Please hear me. And what happened when I joined the church is that they introduced me to these things called the Ten Commandments. And what was crazy about the Ten Commandments, crazy, y'all, that's how I blew up. And what the commandments did for me was, it gave me a set of core values that I never had before. I'm not big time. I'm no better than you. We all the same. We all got vices. We all got struggles. We all got stuff we dealing with. So when I listen to me, I don't know, I was 17 years old, joined the church. All I know is when I got those commandments, guess what it did for me? It gave me, I was traveling with no direction. All of a sudden, now I got some core values to live by. The reason why some of you can't blow up is because you have no like you don't operate from your values. You operate from money. You operate from your feelings. You operate from stuff. You don't understand why you can't get to the next level because you don't have a value system and people know you weak and you don't stand for nothing. And that's why they don't want to associate with you. That's why when they go to the next level, they're not trying to take you with them. So I'm telling you, if you want to blow up, you need core values. My core values say you're smarter than me, but you will not outwork me, which is why I get up at 1:30, 2 o'clock. For real, do me a favor, principles over feelings. It's not about how I feel. What's the principle? How many of you right now, let's just be 100. I want you to be real with me. How many of you can say in this room, E.T., I've not mastered that yet. I'm still like, my feelings get the best of me, and I'm not, like, my principles don't reign supreme. I must be honest and say I'm being led by my feelings a lot of times. We're gonna fix that, right? Make a vow to me, it's not hard. We're gonna fix that. Because once you go with your principles over your feelings, you're gonna be good. Like, I don't really get into boxing now, but Mayweather, like, I don't really get into boxing like that because I'm an old school heavyweight fighters. But I watch Mayweather and I'm like, I see how they get him. I see, because he don't be hitting nobody and hurting nobody, right? But what he does is he does the same exact thing. He grabs you, bop, bop, you gotta stop, bop, bop, he grabs you, bop, bop, bop. And what happens is after about 5-6 rounds, you get what? You get frustrated. And as soon as you get frustrated and you get in your feelings, what happens with your boxing technique? It's out the window. So all he does, I only watch one fight of this guy because it's too long for me. The people be dancing. Like, I'm sorry, I'm Roberto Duran. Somebody get knocked out. I'm Hitman Hearns, Sugar Ray Leonard. I'm used to somebody, Mike Tyson, Muhammad Ali. Somebody hitting the deck. It ain't no, and Judge One says, I agree. Judge number two says it's 5-9. And judge number, I'm not used to that. I'm used to Muhammad Ali going, I'm the greatest.
I am the greatest.
I'm used to Marvelous Hag just blah. Not get, just got out of prison, like blah. Got a lot of frustration, got a lot of anger in my man. And he knocking you out in four. That's what I'm used to. But I watched one fight, and I said, I see what my man is doing. He gets you frustrated. And as soon as you get frustrated, you lose your technique, and he just come in. And just get his points and go back. And it's undefeated because he doesn't go into his feelings. He sticks with his principles. And if you would get to a place where you'd stop letting people and things take you into your feelings and take you off your game plan, if you would stick with your principles, you would see yourself reach success more than you've ever seen it before.